The trochlear nerve only innervates one muscle, and that's the superior oblique, which is seen right here. The reason the trochlear nerve is called the trochlear nerve is because the superior oblique muscle goes through a little hook, and it inserts then into the back part of the orb of the eyeball. And so that little hook is called a trochlea, and so the nerve that innervates the muscle that goes through the hook is the trochlear nerve. So some things, even though the logic is a little bit several degrees away from what we would normally think about as being a logical name for something, that's how it's named. So cranial nerve 4, trochlear nerve, the muscle goes through the hook, and it's the superior oblique. The abducens nerve is another one that only innervates one muscle. An abducens nerve innervates the lateral rectus, which you can see here and here. The lateral rectus abducts the eye, hence the name abducens nerve. To abduct is to take away. And when we're thinking about anatomy, abduction is motion away from the midline. So the lateral rectus moves the orb away from the nasal towards the temporal. So it's abducting the gaze on the one side, and therefore it is innervated by the abducens nerve. So in summary, what I want you to know is which cranial nerves innervate the extraocular muscles and which nerve innervates what muscles, and then which of these cranial nerves has a parasympathetic component. If you know those things, then you're ready for the assessment.